Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome here to the MLK MARTA station. I'm glad to be joined here by MARTA CEO, Collie Greenwood, and also by my chief of staff, Odie Donald, and my COO, Lisa Gordon, and also the new commissioner of the Atlanta Department of Transportation, Solomon Cavanis, as well as Deputy COO Kodro Ada. And we are all here today because it's Transit Equity Day in Atlanta. Today and tomorrow, we will be going around promoting transit equity across this city. And also, it's always adequate to do this on February 4th. We're here today on the 3rd because it's Friday, but February 4th is also Rosa Parks' birthday. So that's one of the reasons why we do this, and I'm grateful for our relationship with the Atlanta Bicycle Coalition and Rebecca Cerner and her team. Transportation equity is an important part of my agenda. It is one layer that will help us make our city a city of opportunity for all. Transportation, and specifically public transportation, it connects Atlantans to resources. Work, education, as well as healthcare and beyond are some of the things that you can be connected to via our public transportation. Public transit is just is a way to make a big city even smaller, allowing our youth access to cultural amenities and touchstones that they can reach even further than where a school trip, field trip might take them. For Atlanta youth, a quick trip on MARTA can bring the world to them, as it did for me as I grew up in Adamsville and took pretty much the same route I just took today in getting here on the bus and getting on MARTA. So it took me all throughout the city of Atlanta as a youth, and it still could do so today for young people. Transit equity is much bigger than just a day or even just this entire weekend. But having a day of commemoration helps to shine a light on the opportunities for us to fulfill the promises we made to the people of the city of Atlanta. It is how we can see how to best deploy infrastructure and the funding that we have. For instance, communities that need sidewalks or communities where students need safer routes to schools or parks. Having a specific day also helps to better understand a community's public transit needs. Residents of Atlanta passed the transit referendum 6 years ago, allowing MARTA to move forward with expansion projects. And my administration intends to continue to work with MARTA to expand transit across this city. While we understand the toll that inflation has taken, we remain committed to finding a solution that allows us to expand transit for our residents. And it is why my administration fully supports Transit Equity Day and this weekend to help move Atlanta forward. Thank you all for being here. And now I'll turn it over to our CEO of MARTA, Collie Greenwood.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Dickens, and thank you all for joining us on this cool, brisk afternoon. I'm so proud to stand here with you on Transit Equity Day and acknowledging Transit Equity Day. I want to say a special thank you to our board chair, Mr. Thomas Worthy, who's joined us with his bright Team MARTA jacket on in support. I also want to say thank you to the MARTA employees that have prepared the site and made sure that everything's clean and safe and wonderful for us to join today. You know, when Rosa Parks took that seat on that Montgomery bus over 70 years ago, she really started something. She started something that is in perpetual motion, something that MARTA intends to support for years and decades and generations to come. As the largest transit agency in the Southeast, we have, it's not an obligation, it's a responsibility, it's a calling, it's an opportunity to provide equitable transit to all members of our communities, to create and maintain conditions such that Ms. Parks herself would feel welcome, respected, and supported on our system today. The world owes her that. MARTA owes her that. Sensible transit mobilizes access to jobs, as Mayor Dickens said, access to education, to opportunities, to social connection, and all of life's necessities. I like to quote Senator Warnock when he said, "MARTA gets you where you're going so that you can get where you're going." And it's access to all of these opportunities that enables people to really make more of their lives and follow their dreams wherever they may be. So in the decades since MARTA began in the heart of Atlanta at the birthplace of Dr. King, we've done that. We've provided safe, reliable transit for all people, whether it's new electric buses, new customer-centric trains, innovative service solutions like on-demand transit and a complete network redesign, a strong Title VI focus on all service changes to ensure against adverse impacts on our communities of color, smart restrooms and customer-facing refurbishments at all 38 stations, safe streets to transit, and focusing not only on the service corridors, but on the jobs, communities, and economic development inherent in our very own transit-oriented development projects. Bringing high-density commercial and affordable residential solutions for our riders and the communities we serve, just like this Marchand development right here on MARTA property at this station. All of that, ladies and gentlemen, without a fare increase in the past 11 years. So, if Ms. Parks is listening, I want her to know that we heard her, we've got her, and we now and forever wholeheartedly support Transit Equity Day, and we're proud to say that everyone has a place on MARTA. And you can sit where you want and stay where you're seated, get where you're going, and get where you're going. Thank you.